spoiling for a cat fight. Come dine with four at five after Deal or No Deal.
The boxes are back. The pilgrims are back. The money is back. Yes, we're back for a brand new season of Deal or No Deal. Dream Factory. Yes! We're back. I hope you missed us. And as has become a tradition, at the beginning of each new season of Deal or No Deal, I run through a few all-important statistics. Our fans love this. Would you like to know how much money the banker has paid out so far? Almost £26 million! There are 38 members of the 1P Club. Ooh. Three quarter millionaires. Only half the people are going to cheer this. All female. Seven contestants have gone away with no money at all. And one person, a lady called Danielle, actually went away owing the banker money. It all went horribly wrong and she owed him 50 quid. And there is also another record that over the years, and of course in this season we will be celebrating our sixth anniversary, a record that has been maintained throughout that time. No one's come near it, but I've got a feeling somebody could soon. Lucy Harrington stayed for an incredible 50 games before she played. I'm wondering if anyone is likely to challenge that record this season. How long have you been here?
This is my 27th game.
You're a teacher, aren't you?
I am. I have got to get back to school.
Well, somebody might break Lucy's record. Who knows? Only 50. Let's choose a player to start this season. Believe me, this is a big moment. Who is going to be our first player of this new season? And the waiting is over for Andre Nishi! Come on, the waiting is over for you, Andrew. Scary, isn't it? Come on!
The jingle's going all the way up this one. Oh, hey. I've got goose pimples everywhere. It's just, oh.
You
welcome,
wind up.
Welcome. Take a seat.
How are you doing? You all right?
It's been a long, long wait for you, Andrew. One of the longest waits for a while.
Really?
But Andrew Green is here from South Shields, Tyne and Wear. Student teacher. Louise is here, your girlfriend. Hello. Hi, she's been waiting as well. So, tell me about the teaching.
Basically, I've done my degree in mechanical engineering and I did get a good job. And I enjoyed the work I was doing, it's just that the office lifestyle is not for me at all, and I thought, I kind of do this, so I got the opportunity to go into one-to-one tuition. So I thought, all right, I'll give it a shot. And during that time, it was just amazing. I used to love getting up for work. I mean, I would get up like, singing my little heart out and that. Because loads of people hate maths. And, well, I'm teaching engineering and maths. Like, loads of people hate maths. But I say it's kind of like magic. Magic's amazing, right? I love magic. But magic tricks easy once you know how to do it. Maths is exactly the same way. You learn that little how to do it, basically, and you just start...
I bet you're really good, I'm being serious. You've got an enthusiasm, an energy bubbling away inside you, which you need in the classroom. Well, good on you, Andrew.
Right.
Why on earth would you bring a teddy bear?
I've had this little teddy bear since I was little.
And, oh, come on. And what's his name?
Skinny Ted.
Skinny Ted?
Skinny Ted.
Oh.
I used to twiddle ribbon a lot when I was little and suck me finger. This ribbon has had it, right? I used to twiddle the death out of it.
So when you were a little boy in bed, you were always twiddling?
I haven't stopped.
Who we got here?
That's Louise. We were skiing in Bulgaria. All I heard was like, ah! I turned round. And I was like... She's fell! I was like, doosh, doosh, off my skis off. And I ran up the mountain. And all I see is Louise lying in this bush. And bear in mind, she'd fell a canny bit, you know? And she was just lying there. I was like, Louise! Are you all right? And I bought that photo. I'm going down. And... Sorry. You can't miss Kodak moments.
But she's not in the photo.
It is, man, look. Yes. Like, well, that's a ski. And the rest of us in the bush. Oh. This is me.
Great picture.
This is me and my little goddaughter, Penny. Oh, she's great.
Lovely.
Little laughter.
Oh, a little soft side just coming out there.
All right. I'll probably cry, in all fairness. I've cried every show. So.
Well, Andrew, are you happy to go on with your game?
I think I am.
OK. I just need you to confirm that you chose box 13 at random before your game began.
I did, yes.
It is sealed by the independent adjudicator who seals all 22 boxes and is the only person who knows where the money is. Good luck.
This is mental, like, can't believe I'm standing here.
Oh God.
Hello, Yari. Oh, he's back by the sounds of it, then.
First call of the brand new season. Hello, backup! Oh, he's doing the same to me. Oh, I'm good. I had a really good break. I feel really refreshed. And Andy's here. Yes, the banker says you've waited a long time to play. Ah, because you're so good-natured. Oh, he's going to give you a chance to win a holiday courtesy of icelolly.com in this opening round. There's no gag, no joke, no punchline. Oh, yes. Yes. Andrew, if you can find the penny, the 1p, in your opening round, you two have got the holiday. Ooh, yes! Come on, that's a good deal. New season. Go on, eh? Find it.
Cheers, big ears. Right.
Find it.
Oh, so, seven, please. Seven, Danielle.
Okay, Danielle, you're looking gorgeous. Would you do something absolutely sumptuous and produce from box seven a holiday for Andrew and Louise?
It would be my pleasure. Good luck.
£1,000. Let's also stay focused on the game, and that's good.
Oh, and Charlene, 20.
Loads of luck, darling. Love you lots.
What do we want? Oh, wow. What do we want?
The penny.
A penny holiday. Ooh, £5. Again, we stay focused on the game.
Loz. You're getting a kiss.
Number 12.
Come on.
Best of luck, buddy. You've been brilliant.
You are. You're getting closer. Come on. Can you find it? Yeah. Just feel as if you're getting nearer.
Right, number 5, please, Gary.
Gary, welcome to the game.
Thank you very much.
Good to have you with us. Can we have a penny and a holiday, please?
Hope so. All the best, mate. It's been a pleasure meeting you.
Oh!
Cheers, mate.
Sorry, mate.
I say, the chap from up the northeast is a bit of a bounder, if you ask me.
Debbie, you're going to be last.
Hey?
Right. Number four is going to be last.
Okay.
Okay?
Right.
Yeah, okay. Absolutely fine.
Louise?
Get that?
Yeah, got it.
Win a holiday. Pick a number.
No.
Aye, pick a number.
Come on.
Number two, James.
James? We're going with James.
Oh, he's had the penny. Loads. How many shows have you done?
Seven.
I've got a good memory. He's had three pennies.
He's got chapped lips. He's had it so many times.
Fingers crossed, mate.
Oh, thank you.
Contrast.
On the face of it, it was such an exciting, generous wager there. And what it's done is produce a very unattractive opening round. Your holiday is safe. Oh, no, I don't think people would think that you're going soft. They certainly won't after this offer, go on. Oh! Comes in two parts. And it certainly underlines the fact he's as sharp as ever. It's £1,000 and a can of antiperspirant.
I've got sweat patches and that, I can't help it. I don't smell. I tell you what, the kids take the mick out of us at school as well, like, and we share. And then you see them sniggering. You always had a teacher that had sweaty armpits. That's me, right? And the kids will be like, nah, man, I've got sweaty arms. Do you want them in your face? No! And then, so... I'm coming off today. Show's mine, right? Oh, hey, Noel, I need you. Where are you? Come on.
£1,000 and a can of antiperspirant. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Right, OK, it wasn't the best opening, but I think you'll come back because it certainly wasn't the pits. Student teacher from Tyne and Wear, and he's got Slim Teddy or Thin Teddy.
Skinny Teddy, man.
Skinny Teddy, Skinny sorry, Ted. OK. All right, and he's just having a drink, cos the water's going straight through him. OK, here we go. This is the round that's going to just put things back to where we want them to be.
The next hour. You all right, Keith?
Going over to Keith over there.
Okay.
All right, Keith, we thought that the old banker had gone a bit soft there, Keith, during the summer break. I think that we see he's as sharp as ever. Bit of personal ammunition coming Andrew's way. We need him to come back with something really tough, Keith. What you got in your armoury? £5,000. Right, two blues.
Sorry.
Right, Keith. Bit of a beach bum, Keith, you know.
Yeah,
she likes a beach.
Yeah.
Ah, right. Just going straight for it. Wayne, number 8, please.
Hope is a blue, mate. It's been good getting to know you.
Thank you very much, Wayne. Cheers.
Yes! Thank you. Very compliant. She's got a summer cold, she's got a sore throat.
Good luck, mate.
16.
Yes! Yes.
Oh, I hope you feel better soon, Candy.
Bit of a better smile for us here.
I hope you feel better soon, Candy.
Thanks, girl.
You're being very brave. She's been. There's nothing worse than those horrible summer colds. Hello. Yes, he was very... Oh, you are. He said he was very deliberate. That last offer was antiperspirant, not anti-deodorant. Yes. How do you know he doesn't need deodorant? I'm the one standing next to him. You're on the other end of a phone. Oh, because you were listening to Louise. During the break, what does she say?
Aye, he's very sweaty, but he doesn't smell.
Oh, isn't that nice? Yes, let's talk about the things that make you good at this game, the banker says. Excellent reader of the board. Yeah. Oh, he likes the idea of seeing maths as magic, yes. He's doing it now. He says, you know, someone asks you to add 93, well, add 100 and take 7 off it. Yeah, it's much easier. And the nice round figures make maths easier, which is why this is a nice round number for you. £10,000.
Look at that massive, massive chunk there. 10, 15, 20, 35. I can read as well, by the way. Yeah. So, I'm ready for the question.
Andrew, £10,000, deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you, Andrew.
Come on.
He's good at that.
Right. Charlotte, 18, please.
Good luck, Andrew. I really hope it's a blue.
Thank you very much.
Yes! Tell you, he's starting to really draw the pilgrims in. Lots of shouts of yes!
Much, much better. Right, let's go for Becky. 11, please.
Becky, you can probably feel it here. I think when he came up, people weren't quite sure about him. Going around like a demented marionette.
I can't help it. I think that's why I get so sweaty, you know.
Yeah. He's moist.
Oh, what are you doing that for, man?
Oh, no, sorry, cuz I forgot it. She's got a phobia about the word moist. Sorry.
She's nearly sick, you know, when you say that.
Yeah, sorry. Oh, dear me. Sorry. Sorry, Kirsty.
Andrew, your pits are minging, but you're not minging.
Thank you. Cheers.
And I hope that this isn't minging. Ready?
Oh,
Yeah! Oh, one
piece. Oh, man.
Okay, you're there. This is really starting to heat up. Come on, you don't want to miss anything here. You must come back after the break. You really, you've got to. You've
come
just
on.
Got to. Girlfriend Louise. He's a student teacher from the Northeast. And he did confess during the break that in that opening round you were really knocked back by those two big boxes going. And his brain was everywhere. But we got him focused now. And it's feeling good. You've got one more to go. Don't play with your nose, please.
Sorry, a bit of a nervous twitch, sorry.
Yeah, leave your nose alone. One to go.
You know what it is? I haven't actually looked at anyone's faces yet.
Oh, keep looking at Paul. He looks a bit evil over there, doesn't he?
I think that's what...
Fellow teacher, isn't he?
He is, yeah.
PE? Does the old PE thing?
You'll have to get him on soon. He needs to get back to work. Yeah. Right, and you know what it is, Paul? Paul, number 6, please.
Oh, you are going there?
I'm just going to go on for him.
Ooh. I hope I didn't influence that. Well, thanks very much, Paul.
Love all our chats about teaching, mate. You're a star.
Thank you.
Here we go. Here we go. £3,000.
That's good, love.
We'll go with that one. Quite happy with that.
I was very good.
Andrew. Yeah, we were dealing with round numbers. Okay. No parts off, no fractions. Nice round number. 15,000.
It's a good round, that. Yes, yeah. No.
Oh, man.
That's 15 grand real cash, man. in all fairness, since I've been here, and it's been, what, 28 shows now, I've never seen that. I haven't seen that chunk in the 250 sitting there. Never done it. And if the 250 goes, then unfortunately the 250 goes. But we'll see it happen all the time, you know. But I'm still, and hopefully I'll get blues in 50, 35, 20 is still sitting there.
Yeah, Andy, as well. When there's three of the power five in, I reckon it's always worth another round.
Yeah. You've got another round in it, Andrew, mate.
I tell you what it is, right? I love Chris. Mm-hmm. He gives really good advice all the time. Mm. He does. Gives class advice. But he can't keep a serious face on when he gives advice. Like,
he always laughs. A smiley person.
Crucial moment. Well, you know, like, it's just... you can't. I'm ready for the question, Noel.
Andy.
Hello.
£15,000. Yes. What do you like about mathematicians? Historically, he's bought a lot of mathematicians at the third offer. Yeah. Offering over the odds on that board would mean 17.5 grand. Still worth a gamble, without a doubt. But mathematically, a very good offer.
No lie about that.
Very interesting little proposition coming here, and it involves Chris. The current offer is £15,000. He is prepared to go up to that 17,500 if Chris could give advice with a straight face. The banker said the terms and conditions of this offer are that you have to ask Chris for the advice and Chris must keep a straight face.
All right.
If he cannot keep the straight face, the value of the box remains at 15 and is not the higher figure of 17.5. Over to you whenever you want.
Harry, Chris!
Andrew. This board's pretty good, isn't it? Yeah, you've got a decent bank of reds and still got the 250 there, so I reckon it's worth another go, mate.
Yeah. Try to make them laugh as hard as I could there as well, you know?
A result under provocation! The box is now worth 17,500.
That's class. That's unreal. Oh, that's a round of applause. Come on. Oh.
Andy.
Hello.
Does 2.5 grand extra change your mind because you were already kind of set in your ways before that happened?
No, no, I'm not. In all fairness, I know. Right, go and ask us a question.
£17,500. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you. £17,500 is a lot of money.
It is massive, isn't it?
I mean, this is already life-changing money that we're playing with here. I so much want this to work out. I really do. It's away we go.
Hello, little Fred. Number one, please, little Fred.
Fred. Lift us, get us up into the 20s.
Come on.
Andrew, for a guy like you, it's got to be blue.
I hope so, mate.
Every blue is worth thousands to him.
Yeah! I've done something right, Andy. I've done something right. Thank you.
Hello, Rosie.
Oh. Are we looking at Rosie now?
I am. 19, Rosie,
come on, Rosie.
Yeah?
Come on,
yeah, please.
It's been lovely meeting you.
Thank
Good
you.
Luck, hope it's blue.
Oh, no. You know what it is, though? Look at that chunk of red there. How much money is that?
It's a huge amount of money.
Come on!
And the game is not over by any means.
Got to get that penny.
That's
sick.
I've got to get one of them.
You've got to get it.
Penny hot.
Yeah.
Go on, Gopal 22, the death box.
Really? Gopal, we need to come screaming back from that upset.
Hopefully, this is going to turn the game around. Good luck, mate.
Shame that it wasn't off the bottom of the block if you had to have a red.
I know.
Interesting eight box, though. 4 and 4.
The punk, I'm going to do a few things here.
He can, can't he? Hello. You've forgotten how wonderfully cruel the game could be. Oh. He says you're right. There's a number of things he could do. So, what do you want him to do?
Make us a nice offer.
All right, I will. 10,000.
Didn't have that penny, it would have been massive.
Well, you said make a nice offer, and I think when you consider you were at 17 and a half and you took the quarter of a million, he could have ripped you down.
Like, massively.
So 10 grand's a bit of a result.
I'll be completely honest. The money that I've came for is for a deposit for me and Louise for a house. Like, we're just in the same position as many. Renting. And I probably will be renting for ever. 10 grand would be lovely to put down, but I want to go on holiday too. What do you do want to go on holiday?
Hello. you know what's coming now. You want to go on holiday, do you?
If I find the penny, I can go on holiday.
Good impression. Actually, no, but he does have a proposition for you.
Oh, I will.
Oh? He has thought of something a little less obvious for you. And you know, we'll find out what it is right after the break. He'll call back, see. Bruce Game is a student teacher from Tyne and Wear. Mathematician. And the banker is a mathematician, as we know. And he says that he's got a proposition to put to you.
Okay.
It's interesting, isn't it? How you said you wanted money for a deposit on a house, but you'd also like a holiday, and the phone rang immediately, and you jumped to the conclusion he was going to offer a holiday, but you said something a little less obvious. All right, and it's important for me that you know I don't know anything about this, but he's asked me to remove that but not open it. If you know deal £10,000, you'll be going on. There's a holiday in there. And the holiday will be yours if you hit the box that you nominate.
All right. Okay, so I've got to name that box and then
find it. Clearly, you want to find 1p, 10p, and £10. But you might say to yourself, I'll tell you what, I'll save 50,000. Because that is really going to muck up my game, but at least I know I'm going to get a holiday out of it.
Let's get a bit of advice from Louise.
£10,000 is a lot of money. I can't imagine having it, to be honest, but it's your game, Andrew. It's completely up to you what you want to do.
Andrew, I think 10 grand is a lot of money.
Isn't it?
I just think it's a little bit shy of what to stop you playing that board.
Yeah. Yes, your beautiful girlfriend Louise said play your own game. Louise, the banker would like a word with you.
He is finding it hard at the minute. I really don't know, to be honest. It's completely up to him. It's his game. I don't really want to influence it too much. Okay. Thank you. Thanks for speaking to you.
Hello. Yeah, he's having a hard time. He called you, Louise, in the hope that you could persuade him to deal, but you said you didn't want to influence him.
No, it's his game.
But Louise agreed something with you. Oh, right, OK. You're willing for her to know where the holiday is, but she mustn't tell anybody at all. OK? Could you go over there, please, where you're allowed to have a look at that, and then you and the banker will know where that is. I don't know. I never know until it comes out, OK? And you have undertaken not to tell anybody, including Andrew.
OK.
Thank you, Louise.
Thank you.
You are allowed to indicate whether it is somewhere you'd like to go.
Right, yes. Somewhere really nice. No, it is. It would be a great holiday, it really would. But if you do go on and you do it, you've got to hit the right box, won't you? And that might not happen.
No, it's like...
Whatever you do will be absolutely fine. We'll be all right.
I'll get home.
No, yes.
Yeah. He's going to make one last offer to you. Wow. Okay, thank you. This now gets very interesting. If you decline £10,000, you go forward and you nominate a box value. If you hit it in the three boxes, you get the holiday. The plus is Louise can select a box value as well. You've just doubled your chances.
Andrew, just do what you want to do.
Ask us a question.
Andrew. £10,000. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Only Louise knows where the holiday is too. But you will now be able to select a box value, and you may select a box value. Hopefully, you will get through three boxes and have the most wonderful configuration at five box, and you'll have found a holiday.
Fine, you choose 35, I choose 50. That way, if the game goes really well, and we're left with 35 and 50, right?
So you are going for what one might term the insurance policy route.
Massively.
Do you agree that is the right tactic, or would you like to have a different box?
I choose 50.
I was thinking 50, like I'm just in between.
If you choose 15, Louise, go for it. Seriously, it's your number. It's what you feel.
It's your game.
It's just an insurance, that's all. Like...
35,000. 35,000. Here we go.
Come on then, Andy. Come on.
First box.
I'm going with Katie. Number 10, please.
Best luck, Andrew. Thank you. Really hope this is a penny.
Yes! Pretty good start. I still need to hit them pennies, though.
Stay focused.
I'm going to go for Bernie, please. Number 17.
Bernie?
Yeah?
We don't want him to have a holiday. We don't want Louise to have a holiday.
Bless him. Look.
Thank you.
Yes! Yes!
Mike.
What on earth?
Actually,
on to go. One to go.
Right. I want to kiss off you, Rich.
So where are you going? Going
I'm hoping
to Rich?
So, Andrew.
Come on, Rich. Make sure they are not getting a holiday out of this round. Ooh! Well, that's all right.
Take that, take that. Take that, right. 15. We'll take that.
No kiss.
15. Oh, I won.
Right. I want you to think long and hard. Hello. Andrew.
Oh.
One thing you haven't got to worry about, the holiday is off the table and it's not coming back on.
All right.
Oh, but the good news is you might be able to buy it yourself. 15,000. Of course, we did have one little sniff at 15,000 earlier on. And then we managed to get it up 2.5K by Chris delivering advice by keeping a straight face.
Hello. Cheers, Chris.
So 15,000 again.
I've just been thinking of something in my head there, you know, it just completely went out. Oh, I remember what I was going to say.
What?
I was going to say, if it was the deal now, right? And I was to guess the contents of my box at this stage. Chase could have a chance of winning that half of the deal.
No. He's getting very angry.
Sorry.
Well, it's quite funny, actually, why he's getting angry.
Why?
It's because it's the first show of our brand new season and all of our hardened viewers are going to be going, oh, I don't like that show anymore. It's very, very complicated, isn't it? You know, every turn there's holidays and there's envelopes. Why have they changed it? You know, why can't they just open boxes? All right, calm down. Calm down. Calm. Andrew. This man you're pushing right to the edge.
Sorry.
He does not want to lose Deal or No Deal viewers. But there is something he'd like to lose. You. So, as a one-off to show that he will react to players in an individual way, the holiday can come back onto the agenda, and yes, you will get it if you can correctly predict what you've got in your box.
OK.
If you deal now!
Ask us a question.
£15,000. Deal or no deal?
Deal.
Deal.
She thought I was going to no deal there. Right.
Tell us what you think is in box 13.
Truthfully, I think 35,000 is in there.
You think £35,000 is in box 13, so you dealt at 15,000. Right. Ladies and gentlemen, our loyal viewers, the viewers that have sustained the popularity of this show for almost 6 years, at the beginning of this, our new season, I wish to assure you that this was a one-off. The principles of this show are not going to alter that much, and most certainly the banker has made it very clear he is not going to be that malleable ever again. We're not changing things that much. On we go!
Play truthfully, honest as I am, Debbie's last.
OK, right? So the order, please. Now, so, here we go.
I was kind of keeping Kirsty really last because I like to say I cry when she opens her box.
Very nice.
Chris, I'll go to Chris 24.
All right, Chris, obviously we're hoping that this is not 35,000 because his prediction is that it's on the table.
How weird is this? Away we go.
Well, mate, I hope it's the 50 grand.
10 quid?
Look,
did you make a
mistake? Don't clap. That's not a good start, man.
No, no. You're the one who created this extremely unusual situation where our emotions are being torn all over the place. Do you want to go with Naomi?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Naomi.
Naomi, will you please open box 9 and show us what you've got?
Good luck, mate.
10,000.
Oh,
no. No, Andrew. Surely you have not walked away from one of the most powerful climaxes you can have in Deal. Did you have a 50-35? Is this the kiss coming? Kirsty, yes?
Kirsty,
come on. Okay. Would it have been a kiss, Kirsty?
50 grand.
Oh! It was. You walked away from a guaranteed 35,000. Forget that it's there or not. A guaranteed 35,000.
Oh, you know how I wanted a gun on as well. I really did.
My.
I don't know why, I just felt it.
Hello. The banker is talking to our loyal viewers. You see, loyal viewers, some things stay the same. You still get to laugh when the player does something stupid. Oh, no, 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 I was only passing that on. I don't think you've done something stupid, but there is a reality. Oh, brace yourselves here. If you had gone on, 42,000. 15 grand.
Oh,
you went with
42,000.
You could have had 42,000. Andrew, would you please take the seat? Louise,
yes.
Would you mind letting him sit there? You might want to put your arm around him because we're now hoping for an upside. You said 35,000 in this box. I'm really hoping that at least you're going to add a holiday to the 15,000. That might make you feel a little bit better. Did you choose 35,000? Oh. No. Doubly wrong. You'd have had 42,000, 50,000 in your box. Louise, where is the destination?
Jamaica.
Oh, you kidding?
Jamaica. A 2-week all-inclusive holiday for two in Jamaica.
Oh, that's a well balls one go as well, you know. Mm-hmm.
That would have been a superb holiday.
What a killer.
Hello. Oh yeah, one final twist. Andrew, when it comes to the holiday, the banker wanted me to tear it up and give it to you to take away.
Has anyone got any sellotape?
Debbie, would you please open the box, close the game. 35,000 that you predicted was not on the table. But hey, right.
Can I just say it, like, why I left that number 4 then?
Go ahead.
My auntie, she's like, she has one of these psychic moments and then she's five and apply at the game. She just says, oh, the number 4 is going to bring you a big fortune. I can't turn down 15 grand. I didn't get this wrong. I'm gutted about that 42.
And the 50.
And the whole is.
I want you to feel better about this. You've gone through quite an ordeal here. Enjoy that money. You have 15 pounds. Enjoy the money. We are back. And what does that game guarantee? Nothing. Because remember, with Deal, you never know what's going to happen. See you tomorrow.